company. You're only making me angrier! Alone.
Thank you. name's Orla. I'm a merchant. Or I try to be, when my business isn't being held hostage by a bunch of idiots who seem to be terrified of women. What was I thinking when I decided to leave Timberwall? Should have stayed there. You've never been to the merchant capital? Well, you didn't miss much. Yes, it's rich and extravagant, but only if you're rich and extravagant too. Other than that, it's a place like any other. Same pain and misery hiding behind gilded walls. It's not as exciting as people think. Or, well, maybe it is if you like living among a bunch of backstabbing crooks. Yeah, now I remember what I was thinking when I left that place. Not really. It's more of a requirement if you ever want to be successful in Timberwall. My family is full of them. I have no home in Timberwall. Well, we have an estate, but it hasn't felt like a home for a long time. I feel like every time I go back, I recognize it less and less. The people are getting greedier and more desperate by the day. Business is slow, I'm not gonna lie. With the weirdness creeping in from the north and bandits everywhere, trade's not as profitable as it used to be. But, I don't know. Being a merchant from Timberwall used to mean craftiness, taking risks, looking for opportunities. Now they only care about keeping their heads down and preserving their fortunes. Oh, love, plenty. And almost none of them happy. I'll never forget the first time we stumbled upon a place after a cloud of the weirdness had oozed through. It was a small settlement, just a few houses. There was this odd, bitter taste in the air. The place was completely abandoned. Or so we thought, until we started finding them, one by one. A man who tried to chop off his legs after they started sprouting antlers. Another one who gouged his eyes out so he wouldn't have to look at his child melting into the floor. A woman in the farthest corner of the settlement managed to stab herself in the heart before it got to her. I almost dropped it all and ran back to Timberwall that day. I'm still not sure why I didn't. I guess giving up just isn't in my nature. You do realize you won't score any points with the Keepers by helping me, right? Those holier-than-thou soldier boys have no idea what it takes to be a merchant in this sorry world. The things we have to do sometimes aren't exactly done according to the rulebook. All right. A woman named Ness has my cargo and I need it back. I have no idea where she is, but she must have been somewhere near Smuggler's Bay at some point. That's a good place to start looking for her. And yes, you'll get paid. Just bring me the wares. You're back. Did you bring my goods?
not safe here.
Back, sir.
Be in for a fight. Stay sharp. vigilant. Ain't safe here. Sure fault to my
yourself. down with me.
You're here to take me, demon? Touch me and I'll gouge your eyes out and bite your ugly... Wait, you're not a demon? What the hell are you doing here? Yes, and if you don't want to get hurt too, you should get your ass out of here. You'd also look serious if you took an arrow from a 60-pounder right in the guts. You really did it, huh? I'm so touched. I'd even cry a little if I had any moisture left in me. They call me Nest. I'm from the Dalriata, but you've probably already guessed that. There's not much more I can say. To be honest, we're not that big on talking in the tribes. Why waste energy that way? Turns out that running errands for certain people can take you places like graveyards. Oh, so you know. Yes, I've been working for her for some time now. She pays well, and she never tried to screw me over on payday. Can't say that about some others. Fortunately, they're not among us anymore. But this time she asked me for something that's taboo for any Dalriata. I've dwelled here for too long, thinking about what to do about this task. And that's when the bandits came. The rest... Well, you know the rest. I think it was something to do with that man from the Horns. The captain. He's weirdly interested in what's happening among the tribes. Even though that's none of his business. At least no other scum from Camelot gave a shit about us. There's no cargo, my friend. I never completed the task, and I won't. If you want, you can run the errand yourself. She wanted me to locate a certain book, and I did. But the only copy I found is supposed to be in the tomb of the good druid, north of here. I didn't fetch it, because we, the Dalriata, don't like to disturb the eternal sleep of nature's servants, or any other sacred sites for that matter. A book. The Sacred Book of Sigils, to be exact. You can take it and go straight back to Orla. I don't care. Take all the money she'll give you for it. And tell her that our deal is off. I'm going back to my tribe. I'm sure we'll meet again, sooner or later. May the wilds be kind to you, traveller. We live in small clans. We don't recognize your king. We never did. And the funny thing, we're officially at war with Camelot. Well, it's more of a tug of war than an actual war, if you ask me. It started with the Forlorn Swords in the East. I don't know who started it, but in the end, the Dalriata entrenched themselves up in the mountains. And Camelot didn't like that one little bit.
control yourself.
You are nothing but a peasant. You have to do better than that. I'll get you back tenfold. Such a cheap shot. Here's just a flesh your ground, man. No! Hold your ground, men. Insult.